Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has left Kenyans with a special gift that could well mean the difference between life and death for many people. Modi has promised to build Kenya a specialized cancer treatment center. Here's our reporter Murimi Mwangi with a story that bears hope for many a Kenyan cancer patient.
It took Grace Jabedo over 6 years and over 3.5 million Kenya shillings for specialized medical care in India to beat cancer.
We had a PET scan in Kenya from 2013 when I was diagnosed with cancer. Then I could have saved my breast and I couldn't have gone a lot of things that I've undergone.
Kwa hospitali, huko, iko kitanda ya mgonjwa na iko kitanda ya ule anamuangalia.
And now, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi is bestowing Kenyans with critical cancer treatment machines of the type. Modi has pledged to donate the India-manufactured cancer treatment machine, known as Babatron, to the Kenyatta National Hospital. This as part of the $10 billion health fund in aid of Africa that the Indian Premier announced last year.
This would not only meet the needs of your society, it could also help Kenya become a regional medical hub.
And what's more, the donation extends to the construction of a complete cancer hospital in Kenya.
I look forward to the completion of such an institution, which would bring quality and affordable cancer treatment much closer to our citizens. And this is a much needed facility here in Kenya. And for this, Prime Minister, we are truly grateful. Thank you very much.
Kenyans spend up to 8 billion Kenya shillings every year seeking specialized cancer treatment abroad, most of them ending up in India. Some critically ill cancer patients in Kenya have had to skip chemotherapy sessions for up to a year, as most of them rely on the Kenyatta National Hospital Cancer Unit for treatment.
We are also donating essential medicines and medical equipment for Kenya's public health system.
Such an effort would help us produce life-saving drugs needed by so many of our citizens, including ARVs, which are essential.
Although the Kenyan and Indian delegation did not give a definite timeline by which the cancer hospital will be fully operational, most Kenyans hope that this happens soon to end the agony for thousands of households who have had to spend exorbitant sums of money in air tickets, accommodation and admission in Indian hospitals. Now, should the Kenya-India Health Cooperation Agreement come into fruition, then the setting up of the cancer treatment facility will not only ease congestion at the Kenyatta National Hospital, but also save millions of Kenyans the headache of having to seek such treatment abroad. Murimi Mwangi, KTN News, Nairobi.